he started, probably could introduce himself, because I don't want to be, you know, I don't want to take, you know, I don't want to be the man who introduces himself. He can introduce himself, man. Could you please introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Matthew LaGrange from Paul Riss, grade 11, and just doing some maths on a Monday.
Okay, cool. Probably, man. So the brother right here, man, he can also introduce himself, man.
I'm Joshua, I'm Matthew's brother, in the same math class and same grade 11.
Okay, cool. So Matthew say he wanna solve a question, man. So, you know, so Matthew say he wanna solve a question. I was confused in there. What's wrong with me, man?
Yeah. Josh.
My apologies, Josh. So I said, but a lot of people didn't know, you know, like why I'm confusing the name. So please don't take patience. So Josh say, what you say you wanna do today?
I'm gonna be solving question number 3.
Oh, so he's gonna solve question number 3, so let's see how he's gonna solve, man. So it's all for asking the question, man. Thank you.
Okay. So, it says that in the diagram below, A1 is equal to C1, and angle B is equal to 3x plus 10, and angle D is equal to 2x plus 20. So, calculate with reasons the value of x. So, surely, if angle A1
mm-hmm.
is equal to angle C,
mm-hmm.
therefore, with reason that it's given, therefore,
but how did you know it's given?
Well, it's right there.
Oh, it's given in the equation. Yeah. Okay.
Uh-huh. So therefore, A, uh-huh. B, C, D
uh-huh.
is a cyclic quad.
Uh-huh.
Because the reason would be opposite angle, opposite interior angle
uh-huh.
of a cyclic quad
uh-huh.
Uh-huh. is equal to the opposite exterior angle.
Uh-huh.
So now we know that A, B, C, D is a cyclic quad. So they want us to calculate x. And here we've given variables.
Uh-huh.
So surely if it's a cyclic quad, then B plus D would be supplementary. So 3x,
uh-huh.
or let's just say B plus D is equal to 180.
Degree.
Opposite sides. Of a cyclic quad or supplementary.
Uh-huh. And don't forget about the angle on top. But when you say B and D, I didn't kind of forgot about those angles there on top.
Yeah,
you know, you got to write the angles, you know, it's that important. So then those angles, you know, it's that important. Uh-huh.
So therefore,
uh-huh.
3x plus 10, which is angle B.
Mm-hmm. I think Matthew's getting ready there, man. So, you know,
yeah.
So you guys, you know what's going to happen now. You know, he's getting ready there while Josh is busy. Uh-huh.
Plus 2x plus 20 is going to be equal to 180 degrees. So,
uh-huh.
if we can just simplify this. Then we are left with 5x equal to 180 minus 30, and then 5x equal to 150, and 5 so therefore 5x is going to be equal to 30.
Okay, so so for what you solve, man, so what you're going to have to tell, you know, other student, grade 11 student, because a lot of the 11 student who are watching, you know, what you want to tell them when they solve these type of equations? Is that advice or anything you want to tell them?
Well, learn the basic rules, first of all, such as, like,
your cyclic quadrilles and obviously how to prove that something is a cyclic quadrille. That was how I started, and then obviously from there, knowing what was in this cyclic quad. Cyclic quad is opposite signs or supplementary and stuff. So know your basics first of all, then you can get into the challenging songs like this one.
Okay. Very good. So any other advice you want to give them apart from, you know, check cyclic quadrille, like, you know, quadrature, like general, like if you want to have to tell people, like what they have to keep in mind when they solve mathematics questions?
Well, like I said, the basics, obviously. So the basics for everything, just learn them and make sure that you know them before you can go into the more challenging ones.
So basics are very important.
Yeah, basics are very important. It's important to build on the basics rather than going into the challenging ones and trying to solve them.
Okay, cool, man. That's advice from Josh, man. It's not me, man. Don't say, oh, man, you put a word in his mouth. No, he... basics, man. So if you don't know the basics, man, and you start to solve and things get tough, you say, man, I can't get this maze right just because of that.
Basics.
Yeah. So basics are very important, man. Thank you for your time, man. I appreciate it, man.
Thank you.
Okay, peace and love, man. You're cool. No problem, man.
So that was Josh, man.